beautiful people. I'm back from New York. I just flew in yesterday night. I'm exhausted, but what a trip. I am so in love with New York. I mean, I can see why it's so easy to fall in love with that place. It's gorgeous. The people are phenomenal. And and the food, the food that I ate, speaking of which, I need my trail mix. I'm hungry. I cannot get over New York. Like, New York was just insane. Some highlights from my trip. I figured that this is the best way for you guys to get a synopsis of my little New York spree, that I would do a video mode. You know, it's kind of easier, kind of, sort of. So, the first day, obviously, was the IFB conference, which was amazing. The production was excellent. We had some help, well, Janine had some help with some of her friends, and my gosh, they put on such a great production, and the bloggers I met were phenomenal, and all my helpers, all of you, Jared, Tony, Christina, Kim, Keiko, Jess, Ariana, Kelsey, Kelly, who am I forgetting? I know I'm forgetting some, but oh my god, thank you guys so much. You seriously helped me, and thank you so much to Jess. You were top notch. I can't thank you enough for helping me with posting and helping me take pictures and kind of be my helper for the week. You were amazing. So check out her blog, guys. It's bitsofbanter.blogspot.com. So the next day was a big day. Well, my friends were in town the day before, so I went out with them last night, so unfortunately I missed my first few shows the next day. But other than that, I went to the Academy show, which was good. You know, I had to support the Academy bar because obviously it's a San Francisco school, and don't you like this, like, curly doodad? Like, what the heck is this? Like, okay, cute. Really cute.
Really, really, really cute.
Anyway, so I had to go out and support them. But I enjoyed it. Firing. It's not like it really makes you think and think of all the conceptual ideas that they sit around their table and think about, or where the style comes from. It wasn't like that, but it was more or less supporting, you know, all the people who want to make it and who have thoughts and ideas in this community. So I wanted to go in support of that. Lincoln Center throughout this week was amazing. Like, you get to see everybody that you ever dreamed of meeting. I could go down the list, but like, I am so blanking out. I don't even remember who I saw or met. It was even cool to see bloggers who kind of, like, they talk through the internet or they know each other's blog, but they don't really know in person, and to see them connect. Like, I saw it at the conference, I saw it at the tweet ups, even sitting in Lincoln Center. So it was kind of good to see this community coming together, and what it seemed to be very genuine. So that was nice. And then I think, let's see, after that, like, honestly, my week is a blur, and I'm so sorry if I forget anything that I went to or anything that I'm forgetting to talk about. So I really do apologize, but whoo, I'm tired. So day four was another tweet up. We had it with Mickey Broadman, and Paper Mag is one of my favorite magazines simply because it's very—it's not eccentric in the sense that it's wild, but they—it's more free reign. I mean, they're still independent, so they have this way of being able to talk about whatever they want, and this—it's creative. It's more creative anyway. It's not so like sponsored here, sponsored there, whatever. So Mickey was fantastic. I love him simply because he wears the best jewelry ever in life. So it was great to see him, and I took a picture with him, but I had it on manual and the picture didn't come out, so I'm totally bummed, but he was awesome. Day five was day five, and I had a couple shows, but I went to the Port of Grey presentation that was in the Meatpacking, which, by the way, I'm obsessed with Meatpacking, like, totally cute neighborhood. The presentation was pretty good. I'm not necessarily into very girly pieces or a girly line or something that's very feminine. And with Porter Gray, that's pretty much the synopsis of how it was presented. Very feminine and light fabrics and things like that. There was no edge, which was totally cool. Obviously, I'm not the Porter Gray shopper, our client. But I did enjoy the fabrics they use, the color concept. I do enjoy when people twist the normal way to wear a certain thing in a certain season. So they presented pastels, right? And everybody does pastels in spring, like the, but, or they do pops of color. But what Porter Gray did is that they combined the two. So they had a bunch of pastel, sky blue, light pink, beige, and then they incorporated this bright orange, like I'm talking like orange, Miami orange, and they had it on the nails, they had it on the dots in the fabric and like the prints, and they had this like jumper that was orange. So throughout this collection, like you could see the pastel, you could tell, okay, that's spring, and then this pop of pastel, or this pop of orange, where it's almost transitional into fall, so everything was just very conceptual, like you saw what they were thinking, the two designers. What they were thinking, so that was good to see. I missed the Jose Duran show, it was totally bummed, but I could not find it for the life of me. I have no idea where it was, and I'm like roaming around the city, and I didn't want to show up late, so I feel like that's totally rude. So I just ended up not going, and I'm really bummed. But I'm gonna look at the images tonight and see if I see anything that's worth writing about. And then let's see, I had a show before Porter Gray. What was it? I don't know, but I didn't go. See, I'm terrible. Like, I was so frazzled, and I think I was just trying to learn everything that I was missing shows over here and over to there, trying to connect with everybody, so. Ugh, sorry. And I had, let's see. The last day, I went to, I had a couple shows and missed them again, but we had lunch. Oh, the girls from SF. And I'm missing a whole bunch of stuff. I'm so sorry. One of the nights I had dinner with Tony from Post Fashionism, and by the way, he's a doll. And I love talking to people who are just as passionate as I am, and like, he was amazing. And anybody who's ever talked to somebody who's inspiring, like, you know the feeling. Like, Tony's only 20, okay? And he's already worked for Google. He's come up with great concepts. He's got this brain that's always on, and love that. And especially at a young age, like that's even more inspiring. So we had dinner, and so then we ended up having lunch with the girls a few days after, some SF girls, Liz and Jenny and Ame and Christina, and then Karen from Where Did You Get That? She joined us as well. And it was a good little lunch. We had a complication of figuring out the math at the dinner, the lunch, which was pretty hilarious. We all could not figure out why. Like, it was just terrible. Funny. Terrible. Gray A-lines that were short, very like mini A-lines, fitted waist, and almost like a very shift top, and cool, like a 3D-esque texture on the front. There was a couple of dresses that had that. And there's some good things for that clientele. So totally not dissing the line. Tibi was fantastic for the right clientele. And all my images came up as I'm not even going to post about it. But this is my little shout to Tibi. I mean, it was great for that perfect clientele. After Ame and I are sitting in the tents or whatever you want to call it, and we see Grace, and like, it's like seeing the president or something. Like, you just see her and you're like, like, you feel this, like, God, your mind is nuts. And, like, you almost, like, see that. Well, that's what I see when I see somebody that I know is, like, a phenomenal person. You know, not just, like, a creative. She's a phenomenal, inspirational, amazing woman. Anyways, that's all these things are running through my mind. I'm, like, trying to snap pictures and totally came out bad. But so we saw her. Then we saw this little girl. Like, little girl. She was like 10 or something, and like this sequin dress, this big bouffant, and like some little flats. And I'm like thinking, oh God, it's like a Jersey wife's mom, you know, she's exploiting her kid or whatever. You know, I'm totally thinking all these negative things, of course, because I'm like, come on, like your daughter's like 10, dude. And of course, I snapped some photos. And then she ends up going into the Tony Francesca show. So I'm like, okay, great. It's like another mom bought her daughter a ticket. Like, whatever. Whatever. I ended up looking about her online, and she's apparently a designer for children's wear, which is great. Like, good go for her. Like, how awesome. But you know, like really like probably what are we gonna have 5-year-old designers now and like 6-year-old bloggers and like 9-year-old editors of Vogue? Like what the hell is going on? I don't know. I mean, good for kids, but can we like, I don't know. I could like make a rant on this all day long, but whatever. So anyways, the Toni French show was by far my favorite. First of all, Kelly Catrone is amazing, adorable. I freaking love her. Like, her shit is top. Like, just watching her conduct her business, she's about her shit, and like, she gets it done, and she don't give a fuck about what you got going on and what she's got going on. And yet, at the same time, she's like posing for my pictures and rocking Jeffrey Campbell tick shoes. Like, hilarious, this woman. And so, she ended up moving us all down because she fill space and stuff. And so I got really great pictures. I'm gonna do a post about the Toni show. My favorite show. I mean, every piece I wanted to wear. It was feminine yet had like this edge to it. They had these wood accessories that like came across from here and like here, and the shoes, like so good. Wood and chiffon, wood and silk, like hard versus soft. That's my thing, hard versus soft. And Toni, like, he wrapped that up and like put it in a package and put it on the runway, and I was like, oh, that's mine, you know, like that's the way like I saw it. So yeah, but I totally forgot. I don't know why, how I forgot, but I met Shelley Bloomfield. Is it Bloomfield? I always say her name wrong. I even said to her, I was like, I think I say your name wrong, Shelley Brumfield. There we go. Got it. Anyways, as you guys know, she is my icon. Her and Iris Apalp, they came together and made a child. It would be me. No words for this woman. Like, she's exactly, no, she's more than what I thought she would be. Totally sweet, very genuine as a woman. Just, I just wanted to just, I went up to her at the Harper's Bazaar accessories event, and of course she'd be there, right? Like, this is Shelley, like, this is her thing, jewelry's her thing. So I, like, go up to her and I'm like, Shelley, and, you know, like, oh, God, like, there are no words. My friend Jenny, she, like, snapped a gajillion pictures, so I'll post that in, like, a separate post. I actually should just blog about her and why I love her so much. Maybe I'll just do that, like, save the whole, like, because I'm already on, like, 18 minutes. So yeah, I met Shelley, and she's amazing. Anyways, so my New York trip ended. I'm in love with Brooklyn. I actually looked at some places in Brooklyn, and I love it. I love it so much. So my lease is up next month, and expect me out New York in November, hopefully. Thanks to everyone who made my trip special. Janine, thank you so much for flying me out there and really giving me a taste of New York, and I enjoyed it so much. I couldn't thank you enough for the opportunity. And thank you to all the bloggers I met. You guys are nuts, and I love that I met you guys, and all the ones I didn't get to meet, I hope to meet you eventually one day, and hopefully I'll be coming to New York. So we'll see. Can you tell I'm vlogging at night? Like, it's so pixely, it's kind of disgusting. But like, you guys should see my floor. I have not unpacked. Like, can you see it? Yeah. It's totally cool, right? Yeah. So I'm gonna go, and but I'm leaving to LA tomorrow morning, so I'm like gonna just put all this stuff back in the suitcase and go. But I'll be back Monday, and so thank you again, New York. I love you. I love New York. God, I can't wait to be back. So.